we'll discuss about organic evolution. What is meant by organic evolution? It's really a very interesting topic to know about the evolution of life. Organic evolution is that branch of zoology where the study of origin of life and also how the life has been originated on the earth from ancient billion years and how it has come to today's age. So let us discuss in detail about the organic evolution. If you study the organic evolution, the first and the foremost thing is the origin of life. What is meant by origin of life? The theory of special creation, cosmozoic theory, abiogenesis theory, theory of catastrophism, biogenesis, chemical and biological evolution of life. So all these things are the different theories put forward in order to know how the life has been originated on the earth. If you study the different Vedas or different religions, if they are Christians, they have the Bible, Hindus, Mahabharata, Ramayana, and Muslims, Quran. So whatever may be the religion, the people believe in the special creation, that is the theory of special creation. What the religious, or you can say this as mythological theory, Here, this theory of special creation or mythological theory, what it says that there is a super power, that is supernatural power, which is existing above the earth, and it is nothing but God. God has created all these things on the earth. That is why today we are able to sustain like this. So this is called as theory of a special creation or mythological theory. Now next is the cosmozoic theory. What is cosmozoic theory? According to this theory, on the earth, before the on the earth, that means when the earth has been formed, the small particles called as cosmozoes have been evolved on the earth. Small particles, they are very very small particles, which we call these particles as cosmos. So these particles which originated on the earth have been created the different living organisms, both the non-living organisms and also the living organisms. So with this conclusion, they have come to know that this is nothing but the cosmozoic theory is the fundamental thing for the origin of the life on the earth. Now coming to the third theory, that is abiogenesis theory. Abiogenesis means the living organisms today, whatever that are there on the earth, they have been evolved from the non-living things, from the non-living things. So how these non-living things are creating the living things. So that is this theory which is postulating, and this is called as abiogenesis. Biogenesis means living, abiogenesis means they are the non-living things. Next is the theory of catastrophism. Here also they say that the little bit catastrophes have evolved on the earth, and these catastrophes have given rise to the new lives on the earth. Coming to the biogenesis, in the name only it is very clear, biogenesis means living organisms. The living organisms are responsible for the formation of today's modern man, and chemical and biological evolution of life. Here this theory says that all the chemical reactions and the chemical agents which are present on the earth, that is the different types of molecules, atoms, and they also said that there are free genes. free genes, this is very important, the free genes are responsible for the formation of life on the earth. So these free genes, from where they are coming, when the formation, when the earth has been formed, what has happened is earth was totally formed some billion years ago. When this when the earth has been formed, there was lots and lots of high temperature at the range of 5000 to 6000 degrees centigrade. This was the temperature that was recorded when the earth was formed. With that high temperature, all the gas molecules and different molecules that has to be subsided and come back to the cooling position, it has taken so many billions of years. So after that condensation and the cooling, everything has been done, then that has been developed into chemicals, and these chemicals, whatever that are present on the earth, due to the process of precipitation, condensation and all, the rain, ultimately it has went into the atmosphere and rain has come. When the rainwater again came back to the earth, this rainwater reacted with a different chemicals which are present in the waters, that is rivers, lakes, okay, streams, oceans and all. When these particular different kinds of chemicals are being reacting, ultimately they formed free genes. So these free genes combined with the different types of proteins, carbohydrates, sugar molecules in the waters, and ultimately they formed the prokaryotic bacteria. This prokaryotic bacteria, what they form? They form the prokaryotic bacteria. This prokaryotic bacteria, ultimately it formed the eukaryotes, or the eukaryotic cell has been evolved. So this is the actual the conclusion of the chemical and biological evolution of life. Now let us see the slide where you can understand more clearly about the different types of all these things which are coming into existence.